Warmer weather means fewer excuses for Rosie and Thunder and friends to not get out and play.
You can't just exercise a dog once a week. You need to be able to give them consistent exercise every day, even if it's for 20 minutes for small dogs and 30 minutes to 45 minutes for big dogs like these.
The Association for Pet Obesity Prevention says more than half of dogs and cats in the United States are considered overweight or obese. Just like humans, there are potential health consequences.
For cats in particular, carrying extra weight can predispose them to diabetes. For my dogs in particular, carrying that extra weight can lead to orthopedic problems, can lead to breathing problems. So it is important to actually have your pet at the most ideal weight that you can get them.
Veterinarian Robin Johnson can spot the pudgy pets in her office, but how can owners tell?
An ideal pet is a pet that you can easily feel the ribs but not see them. If you're looking down on the pet, they come down into a little waist, so their waist cinches in. And then if you're looking at them from the side, their body tucks up in the back.
Jenny Chang of Fetch Pet Care says getting a pet outside should be enough motivation to get them moving.
All they really do need to see is another dog running, and then they'll start to change their own focus and then start running with other dogs.
Just be sure to acclimate pups to a new park before letting them loose for that workout. For today's Health Minute, I'm Karin Caifa.